Here's a new face for you to meet, Anthony Whittington, who is our urban forester. Anthony, welcome to the program.
Thank you.
You've been on board for how long now?
About 6 months.
Okay. Well, welcome. You're not new to the city, though. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
No, I was born and raised in Hot Springs. Lived here for 25 years, and I moved away for a short period of time. Did some other ventures with Arkansas State Parks, with the Cooperative Extension Service, and now I'm back here in my hometown.
All sounds like a good background for us to enjoy the fruits of your expertise.
Yes, ma'am.
What is the mission of the Urban Forestry Division?
The mission is to ensure and maintain the City of Hot Springs' urban forestry infrastructure for current and future generations.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's all about the trees, because
yes.
We are so blessed with many trees here in Hot Springs. One of the things that people may not realize is planting trees in the right-of-way mm-hmm. is something they need to check with you about?
Yes. According to the city ordinance, if you plant or prune or want to remove a tree in the right-of-way, which is the area between the sidewalk and the road, mm-hmm. You need to call my office, and we need to approve that. So there'll be a form you'll have to fill out and get approval from myself.
Okay, well, hopefully we raised awareness about that. Now, there's some major pruning going on behind us. Tell us what's going on.
Okay, behind us we have got what's called right-of-way clearance pruning. Mm-hmm. Those tractors are what you call the long-arm tractors, and they're just pushing back this greenery that you see behind me. And for it doesn't hit cars and limbs come in the road, that kind of thing.
So. A shady road is a very heavily traveled road.
Very heavily. This time of day, it's pretty heavily. You know, kids taking the school and back, people trying to get to work. It's a pretty popular highway. So.
Right, and people love to walk the greenway that is adjacent
Absolutely.
To this road. What about tree advice? Is that something that you can give to the public?
Yeah, I did a lot of that in my previous venture with the Extension Service. I feel comfortable doing that. You know, in a private setting, you know, you can come to me, and I'll give a kind of an advisory recommendations on what to prune, what to plant. We can offer that service here. So.
Well, that's good to know. So they can come to you for advice
sure.
if they need your expertise. People can get involved in urban forestry too
mm-hmm.
through an advisory group.
Yes, many divisions in this city have an advisory group. Urban Forestry has that as well. I mean, we do have currently about 3 openings. We meet quarterly. We talk about goals for the year, talk about tree ordinances, what to improve, what to take out, landscaping codes, that kind of thing. Just get city input, citizens input, is real important to us. And we're here for the city,
Well, unfortunately, we're in a city that is very much involved in the landscape, as evidenced by our master gardeners that are super active in the community. Do you ever interact with them?
Parks does more than I do, but mm-hmm. we do. I am going to start I'm going to do kind of more of an education outreach and get more involved with that organization.
Because they're more plant-oriented, and then you complement them with
Correct.
Taking care of trees.
Yes.
But we're really blessed that we have a community that is focused on beautification
yes.
overall. Okay. How does our urban forestry program measure up, let's say, throughout the state,
mm-hmm.
what's going on with the rest of Arkansas?
There's 4 urban foresters, I guess you'd say, in the state. Little Rock has one, of course Hot Springs, Bentonville, and Fayetteville.
Mm-hmm.
We have what's called Tree City USA status. Since the year 2000, mm-hmm. we've been a Tree City USA member. There's a lot of guidelines you go through, the amount of trees that you plant per year, amount of trees you prune per year, right-of-way clearance, those kind of education outreach, those kind of things
mm-hmm.
qualify you each year to maintain that status.
That's one of the reasons why you have an Arbor Day celebration,
exactly.
for example,
exactly.
right?
Exactly.
Where a lot of kids turn out from the area
yes.
schools.
Yes.
Okay. What are some of the urban forestry duties? You're maintaining
mm-hmm.
trees.
Mm-hmm.
How many trees do you have?
We have over, including the parks, we have over 10,000 trees in the city limits that we maintain.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And what do you have to do to trees besides prune them?
Besides prune them, we do a lot of site visits in parks downtown around the area and look at the health of the trees. We look at ones declining, and we see that we can replace that tree or cure that tree by if any insecticides or fungicides we might need to use to help that tree out, we can.
Okay.
And so that's one of the things we do. course, behind us is a big part. We do all the bush hogging in the city limits, anywhere in the right of way. We have a group of four that's in my division that maintains the right of ways in the city.
Now, what about watering and fertilizing? Do you handle that, or Parks and Trails?
Parks does mainly that. They have their own crew that does the water and fertilizing inside the parks, in the city parks, and we don't really do any of that inside in the right of ways.
We're lucky to have a lot of beautiful trees along our medians,
yes.
And certainly throughout the downtown streetscape.
Yes, ma'am.
So there's a lot of pruning involved there?
Downtown, definitely. Right now, we're not there today, of course, but we are starting, we've started the fountain and starting to work our way south on those Lake Spark Elms on the right side. Now, the left side of the road on Bathhouse Road, next to the bathhouses, those magnolias, those are federal, so we don't maintain those, but we do maintain where the shops are on the right side.
There's an interesting contrast between the two sides,
yes,
of the street, tree-wise,
right?
Yes.
Well,
let's wrap up to talk about training.
Mm-hmm.
This is exciting. You're going to be offering some classes to the public.
Yes. I did a lot of it in my previous job. We're going to hold some ornamental tree pruning workshops, show citizens how to maintain and properly prune trees on their private properties. So that's probably going to go on in January or early February. I'll post that on my social media pages, and I'm sure you'll link it to your city page as well. But yeah, stay tuned for that, and we might have some stuff throughout the year as well. So.
Excellent. Speaking of Facebook page, mm-hmm. You have a social media presence there, so people can check out tips and
absolutely
and update on your activities there.
Yes.
And if there's a phone number that they want to call to ask you for advice,
sure.
What would that be?
That is 501-651-7732.
Well, thank you, Anthony,
yes,
for introducing yourself to the community.
Yes.
We appreciate that.
Mm-hmm.
And thank you for keeping our areas nicely cut back. And,
yes.
And we appreciate that as far as people who are in vehicles,
mm-hmm,
because they don't need to be having trees in the way, as well as pedestrians who just enjoy
right.
all of the work that you do.
Yes.
So thank you.
Thank you.
We hope to get an update from you later on as those classes begin.
Yes.
And next week, we'll bring you more city news.